Welcome back to Beyond Words. I'm Mark Hart. This week's gospel from Matthew 22 is not landmark. It's not one that we haven't heard before. It's not one of those deep, deep parables that require a lot of explanation. It's not one of those really hard teachings that we just can't wrap our heads around. It's simple. But simple doesn't mean it's not challenging. That the Pharisees come to Jesus after he's defeated the Sadducees, and as this happens, they say to him, they kind of put him to the test, as Pharisees have a tendency to do, which commandment is the greatest? Now, the Pharisees understood the law of Moses. They understood the Ten Commandments, but the Pharisees also had expanded that. They put all kinds of more laws and restrictions upon the original commandments on how you were supposed to live out the faith. The Pharisees were doing this. They thought if they could live this way, that they could both hasten the coming of the Messiah, but if they would live this way, that it would make sure that they would not violate any of the original commandments. So when they come to him in an effort to prove, to disprove Jesus' divinity, they come to him, they ask him this question, which is the greatest? And we know Jesus' answer. He says, you should love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. The golden rule, the greatest commandments, right? The two greatest commandments. However, we have to remember that when he says these two, what he's really doing is pointing to the 10. Because in the original 10, the first three are about God. The following seven are about how we interact with our neighbor and with one another. So when Jesus summarizes these, loving God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, and loving your neighbor as yourself, what he's really doing is he's taking the Ten Commandments and he's encapsulating them even tighter. He's whittling them down even more simply. Because if we're living these two the right way, then we are living out the 10. Rather than expanding the 10 to hundreds of more rules and regulations and restrictions, he's actually simplifying them even more. He's not diluting them. He's not eliminating the 10. He's just compressing them a little bit. He says, this is the whole law and the prophets. Now, here's my question to you. Are you loving God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind? That's what I have to ask myself at the beginning of every day. Am I prepared to love like you, God? And when my head hits the pillow at night, I have to ask myself in that daily examination of conscience, where did I fail today? Did I love God, first and foremost, with all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind? And then, did I love my wife, my kids, my family, my neighbors, my coworkers, my friends, with all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind? It is actually not simple. It's actually quite challenging. It's a simple truth put in challenging terms, kind of like the gospel. My brothers and my sisters, ask yourself this day, how well are you loving God? And as an extension, how well are you loving your neighbor?
More shows can be seen on Faith and Life Television at faithandlifetv.com.